Beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, this is Brother Frank speaking to you from the International Mission Center in Krefeld, Germany. I'm sure it's not the first time you're listening to this program, but should it be, the Lord has blessed me in a most wonderful way. I'm looking back to over 42 years in the international ministry, just traveling from continent to continent, from country to country, from city to city, to share the precious word of God with as many people as possible. We don't have our own message. We don't have our own program. We have the true message of God's word of salvation, healing, deliverance, with all the promises God made in his word. Beloved, from the day I was called, divinely called, with an audible voice to the ministry, I just had one desire: to share with the people the true word of God. I didn't want to be a man who presents the teachings of a church or of a denomination. And I didn't want to have my own teachings. I wanted to be sure. Well, in fact, since 1949, when I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, I began to share my experience and the Word of God with whoever was ready to listen. But it was in my heart from the very, very beginning of that supernatural experience that I wanted to share the original Word of God as preached and taught by the apostles. And then I realized that God had sent William Branham in our generation with a direct commission to bring us back to the original teachings about the Godhead, about baptism in water, about the baptism in the Holy Spirit, about the Lord's Supper, about all the Bible teachings, that we should be brought back again, that a restoration must take place before the return of Christ would be. That is in agreement with Malachi chapter 4, verse 5 and 6. Behold, I send you the prophet Elijah before the great and dreadful day of the Lord comes. And that is in agreement with what our Lord said in Matthew 17:11, and also in Mark chapter 9, verse 12. This verse I'm going to read to you. And he answered and told them, Elijah verily cometh first and restoreth all things. Well, what should I say? I've got nothing to say. I just need to believe what the Lord said. And our Lord made very clear when he referred to the ministry of John the Baptist, he pointed to the past, that it has already been. But when he pointed out the ministry that was to come and was to be before the great day of the Lord should come, then he points to the future. And both is true. I want you to know, beloved brothers, that every word of God must be respected. When our Lord says, Elijah truly shall first come to restore all things, and this statement was made after the ministry of John the Baptist was long finished. So we must accept it. We cannot take the second part only where the Lord refers to the ministry of John the Baptist that it has already been. We must believe both, because both is true. The ministry of John the Baptist, by the way, was Isaiah chapter 40, verse 3. A voice cries in the wilderness, and 2,000 years have come and gone, and the day of the Lord is still not here. It's in the future. And then also Malachi chapter 3, verse 1. I will send my messenger before my face to prepare my way before me. Please read Matthew 11, especially verse 10. Please read Mark chapter 1, verse 1 to 3, where these two Old Testament scriptures are mentioned and written in the New Testament. Please go to Mark, as we read in chapter 9, and then go to John chapter 1, where John himself was asked, are you Christ? He said, no, I'm not. Are you Elijah? He said, I'm not. Are you that prophet? He said, I'm not. Then the question was, who are you? What are you? In verse 23 in John chapter 1, he gave the answer. So please, forever, take every word of God seriously. Take note whether it's spoken in the future or in the past. And then take every scripture speaking of that subject or event together. Don't take one statement. Take every statement pertaining to that one subject or topic, and then you will have a balanced answer by the grace of God. The same applies with the teaching about God. We all know that in the 4th century, that is, 1,600 years ago, people came up with different ideas. Should I mention their names like Augustine and Tertullian, the so-called celebrated church fathers who didn't know God at all, who never converted to Christ but to Christianity, who cursed the Jews, put the Old Testament aside, and then they explained the New Testament according to their hidden philosophies. And then they came to the conclusion that God exists in three persons from all eternity, that one God was not sufficient to get all things done, but that he was to be in a triunity. My beloved brothers and sisters, the time has come for me, as a true servant of God, to tell you the truth. You have to go back to the Old Testament, and you have to know that in the Old Testament, every manifestation and revelation of God was already a shadow, a type for the manifestation of God in the New Testament. In the Old Testament, our Lord appeared in a visible form of appearance, walking in the Garden of Eden. But God is spirit. No one has seen God at any time. God dwells in a light where no one has access to. But God, who is spirit, manifested himself as Lord in the visible form of appearance and created Adam in his own image. In this shape, Abraham saw him in Genesis 18, sat with him at the same table with the two angels who went to Sodom, according to Genesis 19. It was the Lord appearing to Moses in that same shape, in that same image. And throughout all the Old Testament, you can go to Isaiah chapter 6, where the prophet saw the Lord sitting on the throne. You can go to Ezekiel chapter 1, where the prophet describes him from top to bottom, sitting on the throne. So already in the Old Testament, we have the two words. We have God and we have Lord. And before you, for the first time, in Genesis 2 verse 4, read the Lord God, you read in all of chapter 1 only about God, Elohim. And then in chapter 2 verse 4, over 6,000 times throughout the Old Testament, the combination of Lord God. Beloved, that is what we see in the New Testament. We see God, Elohim, the Father, and we see the Lord Jesus Christ. It had to be that the Lord, who is the manifestation, the visible manifestation of the unseen God, who is spirit, he had to come to take care of his own creation, of those who are created in his image. And that's why he is called the second Adam. And when he was born, you can read it in Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Today, Christ the Lord is born in the city of David. The same I am, the same Lord that walked in the Garden of Eden, that talked to all the prophets. And beloved, if we read in the prophet Joel that all who shall call upon the name of the Lord will be saved, then we have to understand that the Apostle Peter in Acts chapter 2 used the same scripture and said, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Did Peter refer to the same Lord when he referred to the same scripture? Or did he refer to someone else? Did Paul in Romans chapter 10, when he made reference to the same scripture in the prophet Joel, when he said, and every one that shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved? Did he mean the same Lord? Of course he did. But here is the secret. God can hide himself and reveal himself at the same time. And our Lord could say, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. And he could say, the Father is greater than I. Beloved, I cannot go into all these wonderful things about our Lord. It is just so marvelous. And whether you comprehend this or not, but I live in it. I know the Lord personally. With these ears, I heard the voice of the Lord in all these years. The first time in 1962, on April the 2nd. You may believe it, you may not. But I, Brother Frank, heard the voice of the Almighty with these ears in the German language 14 times in all these years. The first time in 1962, when the Lord said, "My servant, your time for this city will soon be over. I will send you to other cities to preach my word." I was looking towards the window, and the voice of the Almighty came from up but from the right, and I just fell to the floor with one blow and had no strength left in my body. Only after some time, I regained a little strength and could raise up. And then, of course, my knees were just moving like this. And I looked again towards the window and said, "Dear Lord, they will not hear me. They have got all things in plenty. They are not ready to listen." I had just finished saying these words when the Lord spoke the second time, "My servant, the time will come when they will hear you. Store in food, for a great famine is coming, and then thou shalt stand amidst the people to give out the food." These words are just as true as every word in this book. Beloved, we are still in Bible days. You don't seek such experiences. God is sovereign, and only God decides to call and to give a commission. I never knew that this is possible, but then, as I knew Brother Branham, since 1955, in December 1962, I had a conversation with him. And during that conversation, I said, "Brother Branham, I came to ask you something." And that was the moment when he said, "Brother Frank, may I tell you what the Lord has spoken to you?" And he repeated word for word in the precise order. And then he said, "The food you're to put in store is the promised word of God for this day. And the food is in the messages which are being typed." And you know, God used Brother Branham for the restoration of all things. He had a restored apostolic prophetic ministry. I saw Bible days with my own eyes. I saw the blind receive their sight. I saw cripples healed. I'm an eyewitness. I'm an ear witness of what God has done through the ministry of Brother William Branham. He was a man sent from God with the true word of God to the people of God to call us back to the original teachings of the apostles, because the scripture says that the New Testament church is built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets. And beloved, may I mention this, as we are now so close to the return of the Lord, we have the promise in God's word, John 14, I go to prepare the place. Then I will return and take you to be where I am. This was the longing of the believers 2,000 years ago. But now, it is absolutely near. And if you read Matthew 24, where our Lord predicts what should take place before his return would be, and then he says in verse 33, when you see all these things come to pass, you know it's near, it's even at the door. So we must lift our heads knowing that our redemption is drawing near. There must be a wake-up call according to Matthew 25. At midnight, there was a cry, behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him. But there has to be a preparation time, a calling out, a coming back in agreement with every word of God. Beloved, do not think that we can make it to heaven and everybody believing what they wish and not believing what they don't wish, everybody walking in their own ways. Beloved, this time is over forever. If you are a true child of God, hear the words of God. Come back to the Lord. Come back to the narrow way. Come back to the apostolic teachings. One faith, one Lord, one baptism. And what was the baptism in the beginning? It was administered to those who received Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, who went through a true conversion and were born again by the Holy Spirit. Then those who believed in Christ, their Savior, were baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. How are you baptized? The Apostle Paul was asking the 12 disciples in Acts 19, unto what were you baptized? And they said, with the baptism of John. And then he commanded that they should be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Beloved, if I'm a true man of God, I must preach the true word of God as it was preached by the apostles and prophets. And therefore, I give you the chance, or God gives you the chance, to return to the true teachings, the true experiences, and getting ready for the return of Christ. Because the Bible says in Revelation 19, and his bride has made herself ready. Are you ready to meet the bridegroom? Are you part of the bride of Christ? Or are you just a church member? Be baptized by the Holy Spirit into the body of Christ, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Many, many things should and could be said. We have literature. We can serve you. It's all free of charge. Just write us and you will be blessed. The dear Lord and the grace of God be with you in Jesus' holy name. Amen.